Hello, my name is Vincent Schiller and I am from the University of Applied Sciences in Dresden, Germany. I'm really excited to present Encrypted, an educational game for programming in the Unity engine. As we all experience right now, digitalization is advancing at an exponential rate. New digital formats are constantly emerging in a variety of industries. The software Unity is becoming increasingly relevant to these industries as it is the world's leading platform for creating interactive real-time content. While Unity already provides a large collection of components for classic tasks, such as in the areas of audio physics and rendering, a lot of features still need to be programmed by the developer. Games hold special potential in imparting knowledge, which is why educational games exist for all popular programming languages. However, no comprehensive educational game focusing on programming in the Unity engine can be found on any of the common digital marketplaces. That is why I decided to develop Encrypted within the context of my bachelor thesis. Encrypted is a dystopian computer game with simulation-like approaches that primarily aims at an enhancement of the learning or teaching experience of students and teachers in the field of computer science and related disciplines. At the beginning of the educational game, users enter a Windows-like operating system whose functionalities they first get to know in an explorative way. By using the game's own web browser, they are led to download a virus. From this point on, players can no longer access the data on the virtual desktop as it has been encrypted. Only through the code-based collection of files in the game world, users can unlock and open the files on the desktop again. They have to discover the solutions to these tasks by themselves, whereby their possibilities to act are limited. For example, in this scenario, players must cause the gate of the graveyard to open so that the player character can reach the file in the middle before the enemy software pirate steals it. To do so, users can influence the game world with the help of this editor window. There they have the possibility to modify or extend selected lines in the code. The necessary knowledge can be acquired in various ways, for example, by asking pre-formulated questions in the forum, which automatically answers them. If there are problems with the execution of the modified code, a comprehensive error message with advice for improvement will be displayed. Correcting errors is a daily programming routine which can be very demotivating, especially at the beginning. To counteract this, entertaining consequences in the game world, such as this one, can be discovered in the case of incomplete solutions. When all programming tests are solved correctly, the player completes the level and saves one of their personal files. As soon as the users have successfully solved all levels and thus saved all their data, the virus leaves the operating system again. During the implementation, I primarily analyzed how such a programming learning game can be designed to be as user-friendly and motivating as possible. For that purpose, similar already existing game concepts and underlying neurological principles were examined. In addition, interviews with test players were conducted several times during the development process to further improve the application in a user-centered way. The test persons were observed playing the game and then asked about their user experience. The playing time during the tests was comparatively very long, sometimes over 2 hours per level. It was very striking that, despite the long playing time and a high difficulty, all subjects constantly remained motivated and even lost track of time while playing, which indicates that a flow experience can be triggered by playing Encrypted. The game's high level of motivation can mainly be attributed to opportunities for personal improvement and the creation of an emotional bond between the player, the story and the character. Examples for high usability are the use of already known functionalities, stimulus reduction, prevention of misunderstandings, detailed feedback on errors, precise explanations of features and barrier-free solutions. The current implementation forms a solid basis for further research, specifically regarding the actual learning success. I am thrilled to say that this will already happen next semester in the context of a game design lecture for Unity development at the University of Applied Sciences in Dresden. For that, additional game levels and improvements are being implemented and will soon be used and evaluated by the students. That is the end of my presentation, and thank you very much for listening.